I did a big day yesterday. I brought these two trucks home. I did a first start on that International there that was sitting for 7 or 8 years. First time I moved and rented that time, and I had the camera sitting on this excavator here while we just unloaded this Austin. The wind's blown it off. When it's hit the ground, it's somehow erased the memory card. So I think this is going to be the start of this episode, which it was a massive day moving stuff, but I don't think that's going to be able to be recovered. So I just have to do a future episode on starting the red one back up, and there will be a first start on the Austin. Come with Dad today, JJ, aren't you? You haven't been in the truck yet, have you? You excited? society. This is what we're here to pick up. It's an old, as you can see it there, McGrath, an old strap trailer. We've got no chassis, they've just got a piece of flat bar under there under tension. This is going beyond that red inter I showed you earlier, which you just didn't get to see because the footage cut out, but a good mate of mine's let us borrow this Kubota. Bill, thank you. Another mate of mine's in it, he lives here, he's loading it up for us. It's actually his trailer. I'll have to do the same with one of our tractors when we get home. Just trying to watch all the snakes over here. It's bloody, this time of year it's hot and they're everywhere. They're dangerous too. Here he is here, look. This is all old circus stuff here. That zoo I was told you about off Double Bit Falls is just over the fence. That's one of the old baboon or lion cages there. A lot of this old stuff is all old circus tents and rides and whatever they did.
Good to go back, Mike.
going to show you one more thing on the way out of here. Looks like I just might have acquired this trailer. I've got to pay for this one, but it's well worth it. I'm looking for one for the blue Kenworth I've got at home. It's an old McGrath too. It's got a circus tent still on it, but an old spread axle bogey, probably 38 foot. It's more than welcome to come home to my place if it happens. An old Volvo here, I'm not interested in it. Looks to be in fairly good condition, but the cab's, the floor's gone out of it. Used to cart all the elephants and stuff with this one. Had Elephant Man written on it, if you can still see that. Pretty tidy thing in its time, but you can see, like the ones I've got at home, they're just known for rust. Shame, but that's how it goes. I think this will be another episode too, this one here. This is Mark's, but they're moving out of this place, so I think probably end up at my place too. Pretty tidy old trailer. I have to tow that one home. Putting one more thing on here before we leave. Old diesel tank stand. Coming handy with something. Okay everyone, we're home. I'm not unloading it today. It's Sunday afternoon, I've got other things to do. But taking the truck out from underneath it.
Hello!
Came with Dad, didn't you, mate?
Yeah.
I'll show you the two trucks we brought home. This one, as I said before, is in Austin. If I can't recover the footage, I'll say it again. But petrol engine. Fairly decent condition for its age. BMC petrol. Looks like someone's had a bit of a fiddle with her here, but let's see what happens. We'll do a first start on it eventually. That's the model of it. I don't know anything about Austin's. And we've got this old AA entry. Two-speed diff and a five-speed overdrive. Silver 6354 Perkins. It used to be a six-cylinder petrol, but they grafted the Perkins in it. It is a shame that I lost the footage from yesterday, because it was, as I said before, an 8 years since it went start. So you see where they've cut the radiator back into the front cowling a little bit, but much better truck with that in it. Made in Australia badge on it. Just come down later and get the battery out of it. There you go. It's in average condition. It's definitely savable. No big rust in it. I reckon that's what I'm going to put that trailer we just brought home on. Take the tray off. There's too many tray trucks around. That's something a bit unique. You can still buy most parts for these if you're willing to pay. Well, that's it. Thanks for everyone for watching. Please share the video, comment, subscribe if you haven't yet, and if any of you got a channel either, be sure to let me know in the comments when you do comment about something else, because I'd be keen to check those out as well, so it's not just one way, which would be good to have a look at if you are doing something like that. Anyway, smash that like button, comment, subscribe, all that, and I'll see you on the next one. Thank you for watching.
Bye.